What's up, YouTube? It's Tori here, coming to you guys with another Notorious video. I'm pretty sure you already saw in the thumbnail what we're getting into today, which is going to be this lavender frontal blunt bob look slash wig, all that good stuff. So we're just gonna get straight to the point. I'm doing the watercolor method as I did in my previous video, so I'm not gonna really go into detail too much about that. Maybe a little few tips that I've learned along the way, because I'm learning with y'all. This is my second time doing this method, so I'm just gonna let you guys watch, because I explained this method in my previous video.
Keep that energy going up the Hennessy. I need my bag quickly, separate 6 degrees, bitches think they know me. Sex pistol, sit vicious with you when it's horny. Hit me on my cash app.
So on this clip, I'm adding another color to another bowl of water, because once you let that color sit in there, let that hair sit in that color for about 5 minutes, it transfers almost immediately, so the water is going to turn clear. Once that water turns clear, there's no more color going to be transferred, so you can go ahead and take that hair out, make you another batch of watercolor and re-dip if you need to, because as you can see, that hair on the side, on the left hand side, still has blonde streaks in it, so that was not going to work. We can't have purple bundles with blonde streaks. That's not the look we're going for. So yes, I had to dip a second time. Best gift from round me. I'm a dog. I go hunting. And I'm just rummaging my fingers through there. I didn't even have to let it sit in there super long for that other color to transfer. Diamonds might make the news. Bitch, that's Photoshop, like rappers with the auto tune. Your checks is not approved. RM52 and so here I am spraying the wig down because I'm getting ready to plug my life away. It's not my favorite part at all. It takes so long and it's so tedious. You kind of just have to find your rhythm with plucking. It really is like you just have to learn. Like, you just gotta find your way. I just don't think you can be taught how to tweeze perfectly, because everybody has their own way. Like, I can't explain it. But what I do is just jump from spot to spot, because you don't want to overpluck the same area and then have bald spots. That's what you don't want to do. So that's the one tip that I can give. And start behind the hairline. I always start at least a half inch behind the hairline. Pussy in your face, had to put you in your place. Seven letters on the plate, fuck you when I break. I got calls. Now I'm just trying to find the middle of the wig so that I can begin styling and customizing everything else. Keep that energy going up the Hennessy.
I need my bag quickly, separate 6 degrees, bitches think they know me. Sex pistol, sit vicious with you when it's
on. I'm spraying this down with a bottle of water. Because I'm gonna mold the wig. Molding your wig makes it look more natural. So here I am using my Nairobi foam and placing that all over the wig, and I'm combing it back to give it that like fresh perm look, if you know what I mean. Cutting the baby hairs off, laying those down with the Nairobi foam, and then I'm gonna cut the lace off. So I want those hairs to lay a certain way, and I don't know, I can't lay hairs while the lace is on. I have to take it off. I'm drowning, a shark in the water, how you found me? Best gift from round me. I'm a dog, I go hunting like a bounty. Yeah, make my own rules. Tattoos on her ass, she do nice school. Welcome to the Players Club, Ice Cube, Diamonds. So after I'm done doing that, normally I would sit it under the dryer, but I'm just putting the do-rag on, and as you can see, I'm pinning that do-rag down with T-pins to make sure that it's really tight on the wig here. And I let that sit overnight instead of sitting under the dryer. If you do put it under the dryer, do 15 minutes. That's it. That's all it takes. Here I am flat ironing the wig.
Get it, 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 get it.
I did make a mistake during this recording, and I did not edit it out because I just wanted you guys to see that, like, I've been doing hair for 10 years and I'm still learning. I'm learning with y'all. So as you can see, when I just flat ironed that piece of hair, it turned pink. So the heat, the temperature of your flat iron will ruin your color. So I suggest testing, which is what I'm doing right now. I went to the back to test different temperatures to see how low I needed to go in order to not do that again. I did eventually go back and do the color. Like, I didn't leave it like this. I would never do that. But I just wanted to show you guys, like, people make mistakes. As long as you know how to fix your mistakes and don't just leave your mistakes and let your people leave looking crazy, you're good. I got cars, I got bags, I got real estate. Play, I ain't come to play. I got big fish money, he gon' bite the bait. So there's also like a heat mark right there, and then on that side, like, that looks horrible. So I had to go back and dip that, and then we were good after that. They know me. Sex pistol sit vicious with you when it's horny. Hit me on my Cash App, check it in the morning. Cash. In this bitch shining, dressed in designer. She could get me, and it's perfect timing. Gym with the tonic. Bella Hadid, homie could get it. Ass, cash, cash, ass, bags, bag. Cash rules everything around. Ass, get it, get it, get it, get it, get it, get it, cash, get it, get it, get it, get it, get it, get it. So right now I am plucking my part, trying to get it as straight as I can. I use my fingers. I know you can't really see, but I use my fingers to separate each side of the wig so that, like, no hairs get in the way while I'm plucking, because you don't want to over pluck the part. So if you have extra hairs, like, sticking out, you're definitely going to over pluck that part, and it's going to, you don't want your part looking like, you don't want your part looking like a real rose, okay? And I just came to the realization that I totally forgot to add in the fact that I hot comb the frontal to get it laid flat and all that good stuff. I don't even know how I deleted that footage, but I'll make sure I get it in the next video for you guys. Alright, here I'm just trying to get my tripod as straight as possible because I decided to go ahead and cut the wig. I never cut my wigs while they're on the tripod because everyone is different. People have longer torsos, longer necks, shorter necks, broader shoulders. Like, there's always a different factor. So I normally don't do this, but I was just so anxious to get this done and get it on video and show you guys, and I wasn't sure if my model wanted to be recorded while this was being installed. So I just went ahead and cut it on camera so that I could show you guys how I cut. I am using my Andis trimmers. I don't think they have any special name. I think they're just the basic Andis trimmers. And I'm just going around and cutting everything evenly across. One tip I can give when cutting a blunt bob specifically is to never, well, I won't say never because you do want to make sure it's perfect, but do not continue to keep correcting your cut, because it's just going to get shorter and shorter, and you're going to end up with a damn Lord Farquaad bob, and that's not what we want. We want nice little cute, you know, you don't want your bob up to your ears, okay? So don't do that. So you can see me correcting a little bit, but I don't go overboard. Like, you don't see me going back and taking off like an inch or 2 inches. Like, I'm just going over a little bit, because I know that once you cut the hair off, you can't put it back.
My own rules, tattoos on the ass, she do night school. Welcome to the Players Club, Ice Cube, diamonds might make the news. Bitch, that's Photoshop, like rappers with the auto-tune. Your checks is not approved. RM52 and the skull waterproof. Niggas talk a lot of booth till they outside the booth. My niggas like Golden State inbound. Pull up and shoot.
And this is the finished product. And I'm just being extra. Putting everything in slow motion. Cause everything is better in slow motion. So this is the finished look on the wig and then on my client. I hope you guys like this video. If there's anything else you would like for me to show you, if you think I should be more detailed, if you think I should explain things a little bit more, feel free to let me know that in the comments. I will try my best to do everything I can to help you guys and teach you new things or whatever the case may be. Hope you like this video. Please don't forget to comment, like, subscribe, and I will see you guys next week on Notorious TV.